Okay, so why did I actively avoid using After Effects for like 9 years? Truthfully and embarrassingly, the big thing was that After Effects, the UI, the layout, the look of it just scared me. And I didn't want anything to do with it because it was a new software that I would have to learn, and it was different from Premiere Pro, and therefore apparently too difficult to take the time to learn or something like that in my head. Ridiculous, I know. I was honestly just stubborn. I thought that if I could do it in Premiere Pro, it was the best way to do it because that meant it was being efficient. That meant I didn't have to take extra time to open a new software, make something in that software, bring it into a different software. You don't have to do that, for one. And two, if another software can do the job quicker, better, and more efficiently, then isn't that by default more efficient than the fact that you can do it in something else? Again, the point is, I avoided it. I shouldn't have avoided it. And I only started using it really because you guys. You guys asked me to make some tutorials on it, and I was like, well, I can't teach something I don't know, so I better get down to know it. And I did. I took the time, took a few months, learned a lot about After Effects, and found out, wow, not only do I love it, but it's not hard. It's just understanding that it's a different software that does different things than Premiere Pro does, and thus realize that it's two different softwares, and this is what I mean. So I'm going to put this on my shirt so I can teach you guys. Okay, hopefully you can hear me well enough. It's gonna sound a little different, but that's fine. Okay, so here I am, I'm in Premiere Pro, right? And in Premiere Pro, what I can do and what I have done already, this is the video you're watching right now, is that I have some footage, some video clips, of course. I have some audio clips, like this is a microphone track. This right here is an audio track, like a music track. Right here is the audio that's attached to my video itself, you know, the scratch audio from the camera. And then, you know, again, a variety of shots. Let's put this on mute so that way you guys don't hear it. This is that intro shot, of course. Now, if I wanted to, and I haven't yet, I can go ahead and color grade this shot in Premiere Pro by going to like a different tab, like color, finding out what I want to do with it, for instance. So I can drop a LUT on there, right here. I can drop a LUT on it. I can modify it, obviously, set my white balance. That's a little bit green, if I'm honest. You know, lower the contrast, boost the highlights, raise the shadows, raise the whites, bring the blacks down. Maybe bring the exposure down again as well. You know, just do a really quick color grade, of course. Point being, I can do a color grade in this software. I can add some text should I want to by pressing T on the keyboard, clicking anywhere in the screen that I want it. Just typing, hey, subscribe. Yeah, right, I can do stuff like that. And I can modify it over here. You know, I can do a variety of things. I can add text, like I said, music, videos. I can piece it together. Then when I'm all done and everything's great here, I can just go ahead and go to export and send this video out to the world, wherever I want it to go. And that's how you guys end up seeing these, right? And I think that's obvious. I know that it sounds rudimentary, but the point I'm making about that is Premiere Pro is used to edit videos together the way I just said, obviously with a lot more detail and time and care to it, sure. But at the beginning and at the core of it, it just puts clips and audio together with slightly different things, like text, for instance, or images, and allows you to put a video out. After Effects is made for compositing or VFX work. Now, you can do some of that in Premiere Pro, and let's talk about real quickly what I used to do in Premiere Pro that I've learned that is so much better in After Effects, amongst other things that we'll also talk about. For instance, if I am on this shot, right? And I like this shot for whatever reason. And I want to put text behind me, Trent, on this frame. Well, something I could do is duplicate this clip here. So I have a cutout I'm gonna use, and then I have a clip here. And on this cutout, duplicate, whatever, I can go to my effects controls, go to my opacity area, grab the pen tool, and I can start tracing myself out. But notice that it doesn't, you know, trace me exactly, because I manually have to do, so I have to choose the points I want for this mask to cover, and I manually, by hand, by my eye, have to do this. Which, by the way, is a pain. It's a pain, because if I turn off this bottom layer, you'll see that now, the only part selected is Trent here, but it's not a good selection. It doesn't look like you cut me out. And also, this is only one frame. As I scroll through here, you can see that the cutout doesn't move with me. That's a problem, right? I would have to manually keyframe each individual frame that I'm on the shot of that I want to rotoscope or mask out by hand, which is inefficient as hell and takes so much time. But in the same instance, if I wanted to do it in After Effects, when I realized, hey, After Effects has a tool made to do just this, and it's so much easier, I should have been doing it in After Effects. So we can go ahead and we can go into After Effects with this clip without opening a separate file and link After Effects directly to Premiere Pro. So when I use Premiere Pro and I want to do something in After Effects, I can do this. Right click on your footage, replace with After Effects composition. It will open After Effects and then automatically link the After Effects project with your Premiere Pro project. So when you save whatever you do in After Effects, it automatically updates in Premiere Pro. It's great. But in the past, I didn't know that was an option. I didn't even look it up. So I stress this because it's not hard to work between the two softwares, which is why I suggest learning the softwares should you want to expand your editing skill sets. So here I am, After Effects opens. It wants me to title a project because you're making a project file in After Effects. You can see that I tried to do this the other day. So we're gonna go ahead and just click AE Tut. Press save. I'm gonna replace it because I don't need what was already in there. And this is now my project. I'm not gonna teach you After Effects in this video, but for the sake of it, it does obviously look different than Premiere Pro. It looks a little bit more, you know, there's a lot more tools thrown at you at once. And the timeline looks different. It doesn't look familiar, which is why it scared me for so long, but I'm promising you it's not that complicated. Down here, you have your timeline. You can open it and you can modify effects, kind of like your effects panel. Now you have effects controls up here, but that is where you actually add effects, not modify the properties. Again, we're not gonna talk about how After Effects works, but I am gonna show you what I would do now to mask out or rotoscope myself. So if I were to do this, right, what would I have to do? Well, I'd have to take this original clip, duplicate it. So you can press Command D to duplicate a clip in After Effects. It's like layers in Photoshop. That's the best way I think you can think about it. And on this top clip, right now I'm in a thing called a composition. You can imagine a composition like a nested sequence, like a sequence, right? And a composition is a sequence that you can't modify the original clips within. You have to modify the source footage. So all you do is just double click either on your frame or on your layer. The layer guarantees you're clicking the right thing. So double click your layer. And now you'll see that it opens the layer titled whatever the source name is here. And I can go ahead and just use a tool called the Roto Brush tool, which is right here. And I can drag over me. And you'll see it did a moderately decent job at figuring out the edges of the frame where I am versus the background and all. If you hold down on that, the Refine Edge tool does exactly what it sounds like. It refines the edge. And the point I'm showing you this for is if you just trace over the edges here, right? But all that rough edging you're seeing happening with the actual original mask tool or the rotoscope tool is now being removed and replaced with this refining edge tool. There we go. It looks crazy, but I promise you, it's a simple fix. Now you just scroll through, imagine that the whole shot is well and rotoscoped out because sometimes you have to modify it. You press freeze. You wait for the rotobrush to refine and freeze that frame. Now there's a lot of frames for it to do, so it might take a minute. Okay, so now obviously I pressed the freeze button. It did its thing. This is not an After Effects rotoscoping tutorial, but the point is now if I want to, I can go ahead and press Command T, click and type in, hey, what is this font, bro? Scribe, bro. That says bore. Press enter. It'll save that, right? Press V, it goes back to the mouse. I come down here to Align, and if you don't have that, you go to Window, Find Align, it's right there. Center it, there we are. Now you're like, wait, it's not behind you, and that's because this layer is above the other layer. The one we just rotoscoped needs to be on top of whatever we want it to cover. And now you'll notice that it covers the layer. And now if I play it back on screen here, you'll see that it does a pretty moderately good job for how quick it was at cutting out and masking over that text. Obviously, I could have taken more time, refined it more, and did better, but for the sake of the tutorial, even if this was what I wanted to go with, I've done all of that within the time frame of this recording, which, by the way, maxes out at 30 minutes if I don't stop this footage. So it was a very quick, effective way to do that that you couldn't do in Premiere Pro, and that's like just one of the few things that I would always do in Premiere that took an ungodly amount of time. That's not the only thing that I do in After Effects. Other things that I've been using lately are like text animations and graphics like that. And yes, you can do them in Premiere once again, but let's say the word subscribe, bro, I wanted to type out as I play this back. I can go ahead to my effects and presets. Let's just drag this out and type in typewriter. There we go. We have a typewriter effect. We can click and drag onto our text. And down here, I added my typewriter thing. You can see that it pulls in something called an animator, which means you can also make any effect you want manually by coming over here to like your text. You can press the animate button. You can obviously, when you learn what these things do here, you can use these tools to animate text and characters individually to do certain things like this. It's really cool. It's like nothing is that complicated with a few YouTube videos and a little bit of time. And I mean, essentially that is all it is. It's just another software. It's another tool that can do certain things that Premiere Pro cannot do and is made to do things that Premiere Pro can't even somewhat do. And that's to helpfully make the workflow a little smoother. Yes, Adobe charges out the ass for subscriptions. We're not talking about that problem. That is a completely other problem. But I guess my main point is like, hey, you have options when it comes to making videos. If you want to, you can choose the smarter option, you can choose the more efficient option, or you can do things the way you want to. But I know that I've spent years doing the things the way I thought was the right way, or the things I wanted to do, like only using Premiere Pro, and I've paid for it. I have. So, at the end of the day, my man, my guys, my friends, whatever the hell I'm calling you guys. But that's my experience in After Effects versus Premiere, why I decided to start using it and why I didn't use it for so long. And then also what I think about it and some, you know, very quick things you can do in After Effects that might be smarter and better than Premiere Pro. I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Glad you guys are here. And I'm glad to have made a video like this. I know that my last few videos might not have been on brand for you guys. But they're personal for me and they meant something. So that's why we're doing that. But I know these also are important. So I'll see you soon. I'm gonna stop talking. All right. First video in the new house. First tutorial. Man, that focus is pretty